So we're all creating problems all over, right? We're on that path. So Trinity, Trinity by meeting my company, we evolved into this problem solving agency where I would ask my team, they said, well, what do we do? Well, we build kick-ass WordPress site. Woo. Oh my God, Jesus Christ. Nate, wake up. No. Actually, that's one of our guys, Nate. I actually said that to him, wake up. I didn't hit a microphone because we're not that pretentious. But we just use tools to solve the problem. The tools that we take the tools to match the solution to solve the problem. And that could be work. This is kind of where it gets murky, whether it be a WordPress or Word. You know, I love WordPress. You know, and WordPress is a huge part of us solving tons of business problems. So that's key for us. But we also use other tools also. Back to Gene, remember the goals of the websites, right? Content, community conversion. Remember our problems, and let's add the problems that you guys. I think my hit did not turn it off. What says low battery? Do I need this? Play with mom. So, common problems. So here's the match game here. Your brand's invisible. What's the? What do we use to solve that problem? We can use content. We can use web presence. We can build a WordPress site. We can do this. We can do that. Lack of revenue. Conversion. Brand perception. All of these things, right? These are the goals. This is the playbook right here. That's the playbook. Brand perception. Lack of loyalty, inferior products, and inexperience. Operations, not marketing or sales. When you solve problems, you win. Right? Anybody agree with that? When we solve problems, you win? All right. Last few points, and I'm going to shut up and listen to questions here. Because yeah, so. I always use these last couple of slides at every WordCamp that I speak at. This is where really passionate about the community. So after this, go do. Go do something. Not eat lunch. I mean, go eat lunch. Go eat lunch. But also go, you know, go do something. Go. Think of things differently. Go take what we're talking about and put it into play. I always try to structure my WordCamp talks because it's a lot to teach, you know, in 45 minutes or 40 minutes or 37 minutes, as the clock says. I can't teach everything about all of this, but the nuggets that we're talking about, these are all things that you can go and impart in your business right away. Or at least start thinking differently. And if you think that I'm wrong, you can do that too. Perfection is the enemy of progress. You're never going to be perfect at doing this. You're always going to think, at the end of the day, I got to make payroll, holy shit, my car. You know, you're always going to have those thoughts. You're never going to escape that stuff. That's always going to be in your mind. Perfection is the enemy of progress. Don't wait for perfect. Don't wait to have a perfect mindset. Don't wait for the perfect this. Perfect doesn't happen. How many people out there building WordPress sites want to launch a site, their client says, well, I want to launch it when it's perfect.
Yeah.
Holy Jesus Christ. But what we do in our company is we launch every site at 90% done. Because we are only so smart. Client's only so smart. The research we did is only so right. Let's let the world tell us how to make up that gap, that 10% gap. Go help somebody. This is the biggest thing about WordCamp. This is the biggest thing about the WordPress world. Go help somebody. If you have more knowledge than somebody else that's using WordPress, I guarantee you. You are further along the continuum than somebody else. 100%. I hope to be here next year listening to you, one of you guys talk. You know what I mean? Go help somebody. Because that's what we're all here for. That's how we can make the biggest change. And that's how we can affect change the most. So thank you for listening to me. Thank you. Sorry for picking on you. Thank you.
Like my brand, my site isn't converting people, or my brand isn't recognized.
people are just like, well, I spent all this money years ago, why doesn't it still work?
Like, they just, when you present them with a solution to their problem, they think that they have a better idea. So I'll say, well, your website actually is the problem. They're like, no, it's our social media. You need to do social media. I'm like, social media is going to do nothing if your website is crap.
I 100% agree, and the digital marketing strategy kind of changed gears real quick. I see you all, I got you a second. In the digital marketing strategy, the website, it's like a solar system, right? The website is the sun, everything else floats around it, and pulls back to the website. So, I mean, I understand. I think everybody in this room understands. I know she understands, she's raising her hand like crazy over here. But you know what I mean? It's one of those things where it's just like, if they don't understand it, they don't get it. Maybe they're not ready to understand. Maybe there's a bigger universe. I don't know. Maybe, or they're just content and suck it. You can't save everyone. Yeah?
Then you have other people who spend tons of money on building a great website, and just because they build it doesn't mean people are going to come.
I call that the field of dreams. Field of dreams, right? Everybody familiar with field of dreams? If you build it, they will come. Bullshit! No! That's another reason, it's an iterative approach, and that's another reason that we launched 90%. To start getting them into that mindset, where it's like, hey, this is an evolving process. Anybody here and considers yourself an SEO expert? Okay. Right, here we go. So, SEO is a moving target, is it not? If I pay you X amount of dollars to go and optimize for whatever we have at the moment, solve whatever problem. What can happen tomorrow? Algorithms could change.
I mean, you got
business problems could change.
How many words to deal with, anyways? Like, with the search intent.
Yeah. Search intent, exactly. I mean, so it's always a moving option. Yeah. And it's the same thing with a great website. It's elusive. That's why we go for progress and not perfection. And that if I can get clients to buy into, it's an iterative process, and let's strive for progress and not perfection, then they're a great client for us. But if they're the ones who say, well, I'm sure, I spent $10,000 in 1989, why does my Volkswagen Fox still run? I saw my crash over in 78 in Jersey.
Did you do that after the episode?
What's that?
Did you do that after the
episode? Yeah, I did. And in between, I had an ego. But you know what I mean? It's just one of those, it's an iterative process, and we keep moving on and on and on. There's no way that anybody ever finish a website? It's like the job that keeps paying for us. Why do we have that in this room? Because WordPress has come a long way, and the perception of WordPress has come a long way. You're building WordPress, I said blogging shit. Well, you know, right? Yeah, no. Yeah. You know what I mean? And it's like, as a community, we are highly skilled professionals now. And like, we have been for however, many years.
But I think part of that is because so many businesses, talk to regardless of size, are still unaccustomed to the idea that technology is not a product when it comes to a lot of what we do. We still offer a tremendous amount of service, and justifying the investment and the ongoing nature of that investment is challenging for businesses, especially if they fall behind in their understanding of how technology is now part and parcel to running their business and making their decisions.
You know, it's a cost of doing business. It's a cost of doing business.
People who are older, like me, honestly, my age, well, it's just the computer. You can just kick that out in a couple minutes.
You know, exactly. You know, my brother, he went through this great transformation. He lost all this weight and stuff like that. He's like, he gives me a picture. He wants to do this, you know, what's it called? Like, transformation to the, woo, you know, and I'm just so stoked for him. So he gives me a photo. He's like, can you Photoshop everybody out of this photo so that I can do, like, yeah, that's so I photoshopped everybody out of it, and then he's like, "Oh wait a minute, how come there's no the background's gone?" literally 2 years old. You know what I mean? So, yes, it is that, but also, like, we can't count on being generational, because I know some people who are pretty goddamn good at what they do, and pretty technologically savvy in 60s and 70s. Those are the people that we need to work with.
Yeah. Next part that we kind of jumped over, I think, and that is, what is the measurement of success?
Mm.
And every business, whether it's a nonprofit, a for-profit, an author, an e-com site, you know, my website isn't helping me sell things.
Right.
Well, gosh, you're not selling anything on your website.
Well,
where
does that come in?
No,
it comes in here, the goals.
No, I understand that. We just kind of jumped over that subject matter, because a lot of the consulting work that we do in our business is helping people understand what their yardstick is.
Yeah, and then the agency where when I was there, the KPIs, the key performance indexes, or the key business indicators, and what's my ROI? But it's like, that's part of our job, to get them to understand. And that's one of the questions that we do ask in what we are doing the consulting is, what does success look like to you? What does success look like to you? Because success looks like me up in increasing revenue by 30%. Well, your sales team sucks. I can't control that. You know what? I'm not really a gambler, but like, if I ever do gamble, I want to gamble on things that I think that I know a lot about. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, that's one of those things that you're not willing to take a risk on, saying, oh yeah, we can help you. No, because you can't.
I have an author. She wants to sell books. The books sell through Amazon.
Yeah.
And Barnes & Noble.
Yeah.
How can her website do something better than Amazon and Barnes & Noble?
By positioning her as a subject matter expert in her thing.
Her speaking engagement.
There it is.
And that's what we focus on. And oh, by the way, you can buy the books.
Yeah.
Or, I mean, it's you know, the best marketers, the best web developers, the smartest individuals can't solve problems that are inherent to a shitty organization. I mean, I wish we would all be really, really rich if we could. But I upped my game now, I'm driving a Toyota, so I'm going to take the Toyota back to Mission Beach after this. Instead of my Maserati.
Starlight, are there any red flags that you see often in these conversations to have with shady business? Are there certain things
that you need? There's a lot of them, actually. That's a great question. I think that she pointed out a lot of them. You know, like when it's, you know, sometimes people just, they won't listen to you. They know it all. They have somebody who is, you know, better, smarter, da-da-da on the inside, et cetera, et cetera. There's a lot of different red flags that come up. If sometimes you just don't get along with somebody and they don't want to listen to you, you know what I mean? You know, and there's a lot of different things. I think that, like Dre said again, trust your gut.
Yeah.
You are smarter. You know you better than anybody else in this room or anybody else at that meeting, right? When you get that